much. Kind of where we're sitting, and Liz, you know, me and the others that are helping mentors, there's Hello, hello.
Support, that would be really helpful. Thank you. Do you know Phil? Have you met Phil? Would you please wear this so I can capture this on film?
Yeah.
Are you going to PJ O'Rourke tomorrow?
What's that?
Are you going to PJ O'Rourke and Carl Bernstein tomorrow?
No.
You want to?
No, I'm good. Thank you. Solution. From the community, help the homeless youth ages 18 to 25 to do what?
That's what we're trying to get the wording
down. What are our choices? Let's throw some stuff out there.
Unemployment, shelter, or counseling.
So we're trying to help them get back.
So if they find jobs, then they'll have money for homes, right? That was the unemployment. What else you said?
Are they in kind of like education, like of their options and what they can
okay.
do to like
be as like a
start a new life.
Okay.
So
like a resource center for them if they
yeah.
Okay. Exactly. Okay. So we're almost working backwards, right? You kind of have a solution in the back of your mind. So how can we as teen activists from the community help the homeless youth ages 18 to 25 access information?
Because
you could have information on all these different buckets, right? How to get a job, how to get an education, how to find home or maybe government assistance or whatever.
Yeah.
That's just
access information and stuff.
That's the verb, right? So access information about, and your goal is to kind of, yeah, all right, let me think. How to access.
A stable future for themselves.
Or,
access
planning their futures?
Yeah.
Yeah, better.
Area in such a way that we consider partnership good. Sustainability good. How do we know who's hungry. We need to consider who our market is, right? So let's get something in there about how to identify the people who we need to serve the most. Because we've got to figure out who they are in order for us to do any good, right? So let's add a bullet point about how we'll consider the need. Because that'll help us figure out who is the most needy. We want to start there, right?
Yeah.
Okay. You guys are doing really good. All right, how you guys doing? You need a new piece of paper?
We're just like doing the rough draft right there. So
okay.
We know what to write here.
How can we, as people of Akron, educate people on the dangers of pain meds and find alternative pain management methods in such a way that we consider our financial restrictions? What? Okay, so let's add some details about this, right? We need to figure out who these people are. Because if we're going to launch something, we got to give it to the right people. So in such a way that we consider the need, right? So in our research, we could do some research on who these people are. Do they all look the same? Are they the same age? Have they gone through some similar circumstance or situation? Is it because they were just in, yeah. Is it because they're in surgery, or is it because they, you know, can't smoke pot, or I don't, you know?
So
who our market is, or who our target is, or something like that.
Who target individuals are.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you guys are on the right track. Oh goodness, she's still working on her letters here. To combat urbanization in such a way that we consider. All right, what are you guys thinking about? Now, you probably didn't know this, but the first time I came over here, you already had your in consideration list made because you were throwing all this stuff at me, and I was like, I gotta sort through it. So you had already told me that there were empty lots, people are hungry, there's no access to stuff, right? All of those things that you were originally throwing at me, those all go here.
Okay.
So you already have that done. Yeah. And try to combine things that are all like, because you want to limit it to five for sure, because otherwise that's too much work.
Is this the last thing we're writing?
Mm-hmm.
More?
Yep, this is it.
Okay, so
would our budget be something that we should definitely?
Yeah.
Okay, so in a way that we can sit, should we put this
strike players
Okay, you guys got it?
Like, we know we want
you
to
only have two?
We don't know how to write it.
What do you want to say?
Well, we want to say that we want to help the homeless specifically,
uh-huh.
rather than just the hungry in general.
Right.
But we
okay.
don't know exactly how to word that as a constraint.
It's probably not a constraint. It should probably be in your problem.
Okay.
Okay.
Well, yeah, we can work that in there.
Maybe. It diminished hunger amongst the homeless.
Okay.
That's okay. It's just for you guys. So, and then when you do your presentation, I would definitely include this in, depending on what you put together, if it's a PowerPoint, a movie, an app, a website, however you're going to present your problem or your solution, I would include that just to kind of set the stage. That'll make everybody feel like they're on the same page. Perfect. Okay, guys. Lots of good progress on your problem statements. Now, these are fluid documents, so you can come back to these and you can tweak them and you can change them however you like until the very last minute. But this is going to help you focus and narrow your solutions to really meet those problems. Hey, guys. Woo! Hello. All right. Here's the next step. Until about 2:30, we are going to work on the next process, right? So in order for you tomorrow to be prepared to give your presentation, we want to make sure that you have all of the information that you need. So we're going to break up into individual tasks amongst your teams, and these are some of the tasks that you'll have. Probably the most important thing that you can do in this next step is for you to identify your community assets. Now, that's just a fancy way of saying, who could you partner with? All right? You want to look for organizations that are already working in the area that you have identified as a problem. You want to identify groups that are supporting things that you might be doing that you could partner with. You want to look for companies, nonprofit organizations, and governments. Any kind of community asset that you can find. And you want to come up with a list, because eventually, with a small budget and a small amount of time, you're going to need these partners, right? So someone can be working on your community asset map or your list of potential partners. You want to also look at those contributing factors and implications. You already have a whole list of those things. Do some research on those to make sure that you are understanding the problem as it actually is, that you're not viewing it from a lens without having that research opportunity. You want to look at successes and failures that other organizations, startups, companies, and governments have experienced. Make sure that you understand how your problem has been approached in the past. Okay? As you develop a list of solutions, think about the pros and cons. Every solution will have pros and cons, but you're going to have to do this kind of needs assessment, right? Do the cons outweigh the pros? That's not a good situation to be in. Hopefully, your pros will outweigh the cons. If you have multiple solutions that you're thinking about, you might be able to come up with a list or a map to select that best solution, the best fit for this. And finally, you want to think about how you're going to present tomorrow. What will your presentation look like? Is it going to be you talking in front of a group? Is it going to be some slides? Is it going to be a website, an app, a brochure, a poster? How do you want to display your message? How do you want to convey your passion for this issue? And I know you don't have a whole lot of time, but you need to think about it, okay? Everybody knows what we're going to do for the next hour or so?
Yeah.
Okay. So we're going to keep walking around and make sure that your problem statement and your considerations are in good shape. You have access here to the library and to the Wi-Fi so that you can start doing this research. You might consider splitting some of these tasks up. You know, the team that we just talked to over in the stadium were telling us, you got to consider your strengths, right? If I had to create the budget, that would not be a good situation for you all, right? That's not my background, that's not my strength, okay? I can barely use a calculator. So talk amongst your teams about your strengths so that you can determine how best to split up this research phase, because you're on a really tight time schedule. Okay, any questions? Okay, Ian, are we good on spending the next hour on this?
Yes.
Okay, so by the time we come back here at 2:30, this research phase should pretty much be tied up.
And if you need access to the internet, you know the UAGuest works. If you just put in UAGuest or UAGuest, but if you need sign-ons for any reason, if you're not getting on or you want to sign on, Brandon has codes that can get you all on. But I say use the UAGuest because it's just a team credential. And we also, if you need an iPad, we've got two to be rented, or use your phone, use your laptop, but we also have iPads, where we've got a whole library full of computers. So make it work, however, whatever comfortable guys.
Okay. How'd you guys do? You're all done? Cost, time frame, partnership. Yep. And then I would say one thing you might consider adding is why these are homeless youth, right? You're going to have to deal with kind of this delicate group of people, right? How did they get there? Why are they homeless? Because that's going to help you figure out some of the solutions, right? if they're homeless because maybe they were in the military and they came back and they've lost their support network, if they have struggled with mental health, or they are dealing with an addiction of some kind, right? Those are the kinds of things that you might find out. So we want to consider why they're homeless. Yeah, what their backgrounds are. Perfect. You guys did a really good job. All right, how'd we do? So you guys are going to have a lot of fun looking into the community assets when you do that map, because there's so many people that are already working in this area, so there'll be lots of choices for you on how to partner.
Yeah.
So for our presentation, are we supposed to put our ID on there too?
Yeah. So your solution?
Yeah.
Yes. You're going to spend 30 seconds on this, and you're going to spend 30 minutes on that, or however much time they give you. Yeah.
Because I just didn't know, because we haven't spent a lot of time on our solution. We've spent more time solving, but we have our solution.
Yep.
Right. So that goes
and after you do some of this research, that'll help you define that a little
bit.
Define
it a little more. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
All right. So, Alex, you have the community assets.
Hi. I'm with the Beacon Journal.
Hi.
And I was taking your pictures, talking to this group.
Okay.
Can I get your name?
Sure. I'm Annie.
How do you spell it?
A-N-N-I-E.
A-N-N-I-E.
Hanson. H-A-N-S-O-N.
H-A-N-S-O-N. What's your title, Annie?
I'm the Ohio STEM Learning Network Akron Hub Manager.
Ohio STEM Learning Network Akron Hub Manager.
It's a mouthful. Thanks.
So you have a business card about
yeah. Oh, yeah, it's an index card.
I mean, the way that we could break it down is that we've got the best of the topics as far as what we want to do.
So one of the things that you guys are going to do is reuse the unused land, right? Like stuff that's been let go or...
Exactly.
Okay. So you don't have to write this down, but it will be interesting to see how you approach the owners of that land, right?
That's
the tricky thing, right? Yeah.
Because we have to, like, to actually, like, do it through law, they were saying it takes, like, 15 years.
Yeah.
So we'd have to get them to let us use it.
You're going to have to come up with a really creative solution to want these, like, foreclosed homes or businesses that have gone out of business. Yeah. That this is, a good way. Yeah. Yeah. So just keep that in the back of your mind. Like, how are you going to convince them that this is in their best interest, right? We know it's in the community's best interest, but these people, if they wanted it to be in the community's best interest, they would have already rebuilt a house or reinvested in a new business or something like that, right? That'll be cool. Okay. Hi.
I'm one of the previous instructors in this 3-day, 4-day event.
Oh, okay. Yes.
I'm just letting you know that the projects they're working on, it came out of the brainstorming session that I conducted.
They're wonderful problems, so you did a really good job.
So, well, it is hard to bring them out and start them thinking multidimensionally.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm glad what I told them was I showed them mind mapping techniques,
mm-hmm.
mind mapping where you break it down and then go on a specific problem. Because with specific problems, you can have actionable items that you can work
on. That's the hardest thing for the when you do this for the first time.
And now, Dan Hamper is also a manager at the I-Corps,
mm-hmm.
the Ohio sites. I don't know if you've heard of that.
Yeah.
I-Corps teaches people to talk to people, do customer discovery.
Okay.
And so he's here. He was supposed to do something here, but he's now just talking to everybody. So just letting you know, we're all your team.
Oh, perfect. Yeah.
And,
well, I'm done. I'm done talking.
You're the director of the STEM program?
Yes.
Which STEM program?
The Ohio STEM Learning Network. We're based in Akron.
Clipfell, what's his name? John Clipfell? No.
No. I'm housed in the National Inventors Hall of Fame schools here in Akron.
Okay.
And what we do there is try new models and then take our successes and spread them out all over northeastern Ohio.
I teach technology-based startups. Is there a product market fit? And I wouldn't mind coming over.
Oh, that'd be wonderful.
I engage my students in an interactive learning format. I don't teach on a blackboard.
Okay.
I don't believe in that anymore. I used to.
Yeah.
25 years ago, but I don't do it anymore. It's very interactive, very engaging. Try to get them to do things.
Okay.
And actually, I kick them out of the classroom sometimes, and then ask them to go and
talk
to people.
That's good.
And the STEM students, and I'm also a STEM judge. I used to be an Intel Science Fair judge many years ago. So see if you want to.
Okay. Perfect. Thank you. Yes. Thank you very much.
I am always ready to help young people succeed.
All right. Thank you. I appreciate that.
Yeah.
Thank you. second again.
Thank you.
sure.
That's what you told
him? For sure or something, yeah.
Okay, great.
Thank you.
wrap up this part. Make sure you get your thoughts down. We're going to carry on with this again tomorrow, but you know, really get your final thoughts together. I know you're creating some type of PowerPoint or poster, so get your final thoughts down. We're going to move on to our final portion. Yep. You'll be picking back up on this. Essentially, when you pitch, you're going to have a PowerPoint or a press or whatever you revise. And you're going to learn a little more about pitching. It's the last part of the day. And you'll see why having
it. They're back here in the morning finishing the pitches, all started at 2. In the afternoon, we're going over to the Honors College.
I saw that.
And that's when we're going to go out of the water.
Okay.
Oh, we're presenting a bottle of water. Would you ever need to if you ever caught, would you ever need to say,
it's called Marco Rubio.
Yeah.
How's the guy who's famous for that? Guys who have done all kinds of things that really means for water.
Chosen to be your visual tool, and Dan and Elise are going to tell you a little bit about that, why that. any of them are right or wrong. It's actually a bigger challenge to choose which community partner to work with versus finding a community partner. There's generally a lot more than one. So be prepared to defend that community partner. Why them? Why are they the ones that you think are worth supporting and going forward with? So right now, from the University of Akron Research Foundation, which is a glorious partner to the Excel Center, they've been with us every step of the way. They're the group that really takes ideas that students and, you know, professors come together around, and the research that comes out of this school, they're the ones that help turn that into actionable ventures that actually go about changing the world. So that's a really wonderful asset that the university has.
equation is whatever you're building, somebody needs to be willing to pay you more than it costs you to build it, or you do not have a business. Okay? And it's not that hard. I'll go back to the example I gave you before. I told you when I was standing in line at the airport, I asked people, would you give me $5 right now if I could just give you your boarding pass and you could skip the line? And people were saying, I'll pay you $20, just get me out of this line. That's a value equation. What I was saying is, find out what people are willing to pay,